What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to install and use the Sign Artist plugin in Rust. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Customizing your Rust server can involve lots of potential features, with the most popular ones being custom images. But this isn't just something you're going to find naturally in the game. It's going to take plugins, and today we're going over one of the best. With the Sign Artist plugin, you can add signs to things like in-game shops, bases, and more, all while making them more personalized. Let's go over how to get started. Head to Sign Artist on UMod and then press the blue download button and save this file somewhere easily accessible on your computer. Next, head towards your Apex server panel and stop the server. Once that's done, click FTP file access near the top left, log in, and then find and enter the Oxide directory. From here, click into the plugins folder and press upload in the top left corner. And on the next page, you can drag and drop the downloaded file into the upload area. Wait for this to reach 100%, and then you can use your server name at the top of the page to return to the main panel where you can restart the server. These Rust plugins are only going to work if UMod is active, which is already enabled by default in the customizations on the panel. That being said, if you notice any problems, then head into that page and double check that it is turned on. After installing the plugin, you're going to want to run an Oxide permission command from your console on the server panel. Enter this command, replacing the name or Steam ID with your information. Now that you have access, let's go over the commands and permissions that you can use, plus a few examples and plugin settings. The main functionality from Sign Artist is its three main commands, allowing you to take full control over your signs. Before using any of these, you're going to have to assign the correct permissions to your account through the Oxide command. We do have a separate guide on using this command if you need a refresher, and that'll be linked down below. And since it can be a bit confusing at first, let's go over some examples. The main feature from the plugin is the ability to use URLs for posting images on signs. All you have to do is copy a picture's link and then paste it with the /SIL command. These can come from anywhere online, but you're going to want to make sure the file format is a PNG or a JPEG. Finally, make sure you're looking at the sign when you enter the command to get everything working. If you're not wanting to use a URL, then you can also try generating custom text, but this is a little bit more complicated. You can use the /SILT command and use arguments to customize your sign, like this. The colors format uses hex codes, which you can find in the link down below. And finally, for any owners wanting to tweak some of the Sign Artist settings, here is how you can get to the config files. Log in to your FTP file access from the server panel, and then head towards the Oxide directory and enter the config folder. Find the Sign Artist file and then press edit to the far right, and then inside the panel editor, you can make any necessary changes. When you're done, make sure to press save at the top, and then you can head back to the main panel and restart the server. As for some of the changes you can make, here are some recommended settings that you can try to see if they work for you. If you're unable to upload the images, make sure to check your file type first. Try to mainly stick with PNG or JPEG formats, since these are fully supported in the plugin. If that isn't the issue, then it might be from a lack of permissions. Make sure you've added Sign Artist URL to your account, or that you're in a group that can use the permission. This also applies to custom text signs, so double check that Sign Artist text is also assigned properly. If you edit the config files and the changes aren't saving in-game, make sure to save the file manually before restarting the server. If you do that and it's still not saving, it could be a formatting issue. In other words, don't remove any commas, quotation marks, or other characters, since these are critical to the config's code. This typically happens after a Rust update, but sometimes your signs are going to break. In these situations, use the /SIL restore all command. And as long as you have the permission, that should solve the problem. Custom signs are a great way to add personality to your servers, welcome new players, and more, and it's super easy to do just by installing the Sign Artist plugin. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.